You want to know a little about, a little bit about, you want to know a little about, a little bit about, you want to know a little about, a little bit about, a little bit about my cows, 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 a little bit about my cows. Well, tell you, well, tell you, well, tell you, a little bit about my cows, a little bit about my cows, a little bit about my cows.
I got a brock to me. 45 in. I got a brock to me. 45 in.
Well,
there's a lot of different cows. I got some Shirley. That's a yellow one.
Angus, they're black.
Black.
And then Hereford is red.
There's a lot of different cows.
A little bit about my cows, 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 a little bit about my cows.
My name is Garland C. Hirschi, Rockville, Utah. Born in Rockville, 1926. When I first was born that way, my dad had a little, just a two-room house. When I was growing up, everybody in town used to have cattle. Then you had to raise what you lived on then. Everybody at least had one or two pigs that they'd kill. Never kill a cow in the olden days until November, December because of they had no refrigeration, and the way they'd have to keep their meat was they'd hang it up on the side of the house where they had a great big nail. And they'd hang it out in the middle of the night, all night long, and then they'd bring it in the daytime. They'd cover it with a quilt or something like that, and then they'd take it back and forth, and it'd stay cold all day in the house, and it'd never spoil until they'd eat it up. They'd cut steaks and whatever they wanted from it off the cow, you know, ribs or whatever they was having whatever day, you know, until it was eaten up. They'd live off the what they raised in the summertime, like their gardens and that, and then they'd have pig meat, cattle meat for wintertime. Then you had to raise what you lived on then. I'll give you an imitation to like my cow's sound. When you take their calves away from them is on the count of they get a tight bag, you know, and they try to find their calf so they can relieve that pain. And for now they'll bawl for 3 days. Just keep it bawling until pain goes away, and that's the reason the cow bawls when you take the calf away from her. Cows they'll bawl because they're used to you or something like that when you come around, or there's another cow over in another field that they bawl back and forth. Just keep the bawling. They'll bawl for 3 days. Bawling. Well, they know one another because when I change them field to field, why they'll, you turn them in with them and they'll bunt one another and chase one another around until they get acquainted. They act like you and I when we haven't seen somebody for a long time, you know. Garland C. Hirschi, Rockville, Utah.